It's the case that's left a state heartbroken. Baden Bond, the toddler abandoned in a park at dark, left to die. His father will serve 12 years behind bars as punishment for his callous crime, while the boy's mother is now free with time already served.
When Baden Bond was abandoned as night fell in a park by the Logan River in 2007, he didn't stand a chance.
This vulnerable, abandoned toddler presumably was attracted to the water's edge and drowned.
It was callous, heartless, inhumane. The two-year-old was deliberately left in mortal danger, but his father, Shane Arthur Simpson, just drove off, got on with his life and lied about it for a decade.
His remaining time alive was probably full of fear.
Justice Peter Applegarth sentenced the ICE addict to 12 years jail for manslaughter. Simpson will have to serve that sentence in its entirety because of the no body, no parole laws. The way Baden was treated in his short life defies belief. His parents called him names, evil, the devil's child. They rarely changed his nappies and they kept him in a locked bedroom.
Against the background of neglect and malice, abandoning Baden and then never returning to save him places this in the worst category of case of manslaughter by criminal neglect.
His mother, Dina Colleen Bond, told lie after lie about where Baden was, deceiving the Department of Child Safety. For that, she was handed a three-year sentence, but because she spent the last two locked up, she was freed today. Simpson claims he was hoping someone would find Baden and take care of him, but Justice Applegarth said that was fanciful. He said if he'd left him at a hospital, a preschool, or even on the main street of Beenleigh, at least that would have given him some chance of survival.
Your gross negligence is of an extreme kind.
The little boy's parents have never expressed any remorse.
It's a very strong sentence in the circumstances. And he was robbed not only of his life, but of his childhood. Siblings were robbed of having a brother.
Baden would have, should have, been 13 years old if he were alive today.
Queensland is watching the number one news hour.